Hello everyone, my name is Mrs. Sinclair and I teach first grade in Decatur, Georgia. And today I want to create a fun math lesson using 3D shapes. I want us to go on a hunt all around the house. I want us to ask our parents' permission to go outside to look for shapes. Shapes are all around us. Today we are going to find 10 3D shapes and we're going to use those shapes to help us with our lesson. We're going to learn all about data today. We're going to learn how to organize, represent, and interpret data. Now, I know those were a lot of big words, so first, we need to figure out what they all mean. So let's talk about the word data. Data means information that was collected, and today we're going to collect information on 3D shapes that we find around our house. We're going to take these 3D shapes and we're going to organize them. We're going to sort them by the name of each of the 3D shapes. We're going to put all of the cones on one side, all of the rectangular prisms on the other side, and all of the cylinders on another side. We are then going to use a picture graph to represent our data. We're going to use pictures and symbols to help us create a chart so that we can see what we've collected, so we can see the information. We are then going to use this picture graph to help us interpret our data. What is this data telling me? What is this information telling us? Is it telling us that I have more cones in my house than cylinders? What do you think you have the most of in your house? I'm going to say that I have a lot of cones in my house. Let's talk about 3D shapes. Remember that 3D shapes are not flat like this. They are solid shapes. This 3D shape, a rectangular prism, has length, height, and width. This rectangular prism has six faces all in the shape of a rectangle. This is one of the shapes that we are going to be hunting for today. We're also going to be looking for cylinders, like my water bottle. A cylinder is a solid object with two identical flat ends that are circular, like that, and one curved side. We're also going to be looking for cones, like this one. A cone has one flat circular base, and it comes up to a point with one curved side. I'm so excited to hunt for these shapes in my house, and I want you to press pause and look for 10 3D shapes in your house. Remember, we're only looking for rectangular prisms, cylinders, and cones. Meet me back here so we can talk about all the data that we collected. Fun looking for shapes around my house. I found so many, but I had to keep in mind that we were only looking for three specific 3D shapes. So now I need your help to organize them. Let's see. Let's name all of them, and then we can sort them by 3D shape. Let's start with my water bottle. We talked about this earlier, and we said that this water bottle is a cylinder because it has two identical flat ends that are circular with one curved side. So let's put all the cylinders on this side. This kind of reminds me of my water bottle. What do you think this is? You're right, it's a cylinder. So let's put this right here. What about this? Spaghetti. Does it remind you of the cylinder? Does it have a curved side? Does it remind you of my party hat? You're right, it's a rectangular prism because it has six faces in the shape of a rectangle. Good, let's put those right here in the middle. Here's the tissue box. We talked about this earlier. Remember that we said that the tissue box was a rectangular prism, right? those right here. What about this? Looking at just the bottom here. This is nice and curved. Not really like flat like this here. It's flat end, like a circle. And so is this top part over here. What do you think this is? You're right, it's a cylinder. Let's put that right here. What about this pancake mix? What do you think this is? Do you see any curved sides? No, I don't either. You're right, it's a rectangular prism. Let's put that right here. What about these books? It's a box that has books inside. What do you think this is? You're getting so good at this. You're right, a rectangular prism. What about this? What is this? Wow, that was a little bit loud. Does this have any six faces that look like rectangles? No. Doesn't look like everything else here, huh? Do you think we can put it here? No, you're right. These don't have a point coming up. This does look like my party hat. This has to be a comb. Let's put that right here. What about this can? This can of tomato soup. Kind of reminds me of my water bottle. You're right, it's a cylinder. And the last thing I found was this candle. Circular, and curved side. You're right, it's a cylinder. Now I have all of my information, all of my data organized. I have my cylinders over here, my rectangular prisms over here, and my one cone over here. I thought I had more cones in my house. Okay, so now we've already organized our data, and here is our picture. We've organized all of our 3D shapes and we've put them into three groups. Now we're going to take this data and transfer it onto this table here. We're going to create a picture graph using these symbols down here to help us. So, before we get started, we need to think about what a good title would be. Now, I don't want to name this "How Many Monkeys Are Jumping on My Bed." Were we talking about monkeys? No. Should we name this "How Miss Sinclair's Students Got Home from School Today"? No, we weren't talking about that. What would be a good title for this picture graph? Let's take 10 seconds to think about a good title. It could be in the form of a question. Go ahead and take some time to think. Okay, I thought of something. What if we put as our title, how many 3D shapes can you find at home? What do you think about that? I hope it's similar to what you thought of. But remember, you'll be doing your own picture graph later. Now, let's start. Cones. How many cones did I find at home? Let's take a look at our picture. How many cones did I find? You're right. I just had one cone in my house. So, I'm going to grab my symbol here, my little picture, and I'm going to put it there because I only found one cone. What about rectangular prisms? Let's go back to our picture. How many rectangular prisms did I find? You're right. I found four. One, two, three, four. Great job. going to grab my symbol again, a rectangular prism, and put in 1, 2, 3, 4. Last, we have cylinders. How many cylinders did I find? Yep, there were 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Grab my symbol so that I can represent this with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I'm going to add my totals here. I had how many cones? Yep, just 1. How many rectangular prisms? Correct, 4. And how many cylinders? 5. And now we've created our picture graph. We have our table here that has helped us with creating our picture graph. Now that we've organized our data, that we've represented our data, it's time for us to interpret this data. What does this all mean? What is this information telling me about the shapes that I have in my house? So let's begin to interpret this data. If we look at our table here, we found out that in my house, I found 1 cone, 4 rectangular prisms, and 5 cylinders. So let's use this table, this picture graph, to help us answer some of these questions. The first question is asking, how many cylinders are there? So if we look at our table and we look at the cylinders, how many cylinders did we say that I found? You're right, 5. You can easily look at our totals here, or you can count back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, the next question is asking, how many cones are there? How many cones did I find in my house? Well, if you don't remember, you can look back at the data, and the data shows that we found 1 cone, 1 cone. This next question is asking, what 3D shape was found the most? What does that mean? Let's look at our data. Let's look at our table here. Which 3D shape was found the most? That means, did I find more cones than anything else? Did I find the most rectangular prisms? Or was there more cylinders than anything else? Which one has more? Which one did I find more of in my house? Right, cylinders. I found 5 cylinders. That's the biggest number here. I found this shape the most in my house. So my answer would be not 5, which is what I see a lot of, but my question is asking what 3D shape, and the 3D shape that I found the most of is cylinders. All right, the next question is asking, what 3D shape was found the least? What is the least shape that was found in my house? Let's look at our data. Our data shows that I found 1 cone, 4 rectangular prisms, and 5 cylinders. So which one is the least? It doesn't have that many. I didn't find too many of them. The least amount would be 1. And that would mean that I found the least amount of, right, of cones. The shape that I found the least was cones. Very good. All right, this next question here is asking, how many cylinders and rectangular prisms are there? How many cylinders and rectangular prisms? The word "and" is telling me that I want to know cylinders and rectangular prisms. That means that I need to add those together. So, I need to know the numbers of each. Let's go back to our data to figure this one out. How many cylinders did we find? Right, 5. Well, I want to know cylinders and, that means I'm going to add them together. Cylinders and rectangular prisms. How many rectangular prisms did I find? According to my data, I found 4. Good. So now I'm going to add 5 and 4. 5 plus 4 equals what? I'm going to add my cylinders together with my rectangular prisms. I'm going to add these two together. So I'm sure some of you know what 5 plus 4 is right away. But if you don't, we can just count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9. There are 9 cylinders and rectangular prisms all together. Great job! The next question is asking how many more rectangular prisms are there than cones? I'm trying to figure out how many more rectangular prisms I found in my house than cones. So I'm only working with rectangular prisms and cones right now. I don't even have to look at cylinders because the question did not ask me anything about cylinders. So let's pretend this is not here right now. I want to know how many more of these rectangular prisms I found than cones. I know that I found 4 rectangular prisms and 1 cone. So how many more rectangular prisms is that? We can draw a line right here. I know I found 1 cone and 1 rectangular prism. But then rectangular prism keeps on going because I found some more. I stopped right here at cones. I only found 1. But I can't stop right here with rectangular prisms because I found more than 1. But how many more did I find? So if I draw my line right here, because at this point they have the same 1, but if I keep counting, I have 1, 2, 3 more. I found 3 more rectangular prisms than I did cones. You can also figure this out by subtracting these two numbers. In first grade, we take our bigger number, which is 4, and we'll subtract 1 cone, and that will give us 3. 4 take away 1 is 3. So if you did not want to do it this way, you can grab the 4 rectangular prisms, we'll take away the 1 cone that was just like this, and then we have these 3 because we found 3 more rectangular prisms than we did cones. The next question is asking, how many 3D shapes were found all together? That's a clue. That is a key word, and that word altogether tells me something. I know that I have to do what? Do I need to add or subtract when I hear or read the word altogether? Right, I'm going to add, and I want to know how many I found altogether. That means I need to add all of the shapes that I found. So if you're really good at adding 3 different numbers, you would add 1 cone. That's how many rectangular prisms? We can look back at our data. 4 rectangular prisms. And how many cylinders? Right, 5. We want to add these 3 numbers together. If that is too difficult, you can just simply use your picture here
to count all of the shapes together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that makes sense because I was looking for 10 shapes when I first started. So how many 3D shapes were found all together? 10 shapes. Very good. Now that we are done interpreting our data, and there are many other questions that could be asked about this data, you can now create your own chart, your own table that looks like this. You would write your title, cones, rectangular prisms, and cylinders, and then you would draw in your own pictures and find your own totals. And then you can start discussing your data. What did you find out? How many of each shade did you find in your house? I hope you have fun with this. Bye. Today we learned all about data, and I hope that now the words organize, represent, and interpret are no longer that scary. I hope you know now that organizing data just means that you are sorting your information. You are organizing your information. Representing means that you are using symbols, pictures, paper, charts, tables to help you see your information. And interpreting your data just means that you are talking to someone or yourself about what you found. What is your data telling you? So, another thing is that you can use data, or you can find data, collect information on just about anything that you are interested in. Today, I'm going to be collecting data on what I should cook for dinner. I'm going to give my family 3 choices, and the choice that is chosen the most is probably what I'm going to cook today. You can do that at home with dessert. You can do that at home with your family's favorite color. Just give them 3 choices and then collect that data. You can always represent it by making yourself a table, a picture graph, and then talking about it, figuring out what information you figured out. Math is so much fun. I love using math in the real world. Shapes are all around us, and I hope that talking about 3D shapes was a reminder of how fun shapes can be. And I hope that most of all, you've enjoyed this lesson and learned to love math a little bit more, just like I do. Bye.